Pierce Brosnan is not a stranger to suspense thrillers. His latest movie, The Foreigner, co-stars Jackie Chan, and it's no exception. Pierce plays a British government official overseeing a bombing investigation, and in the process, some dark secrets unfold. Take a look.
I haven't been affiliated with the IRA for 30 years. When I was, I fought hard against the violence. I went to prison for what I did and paid my debt. Now I serve the politics of both sides, trying to heal the wounds and bridge the divide. Again, my sincere condolences, but there's nothing I can do.
What if your wife and daughter were killed by a bomb?
I do everything in my power to get justice.
Pierce, good morning. Good to see you.
Good morning, Matt. Good to see you, too.
We were talking a second ago that we have known each other for quite a while, probably 25 years or so. And in all the time I've known you, all the interviews I've done with you, I never knew you were a huge, or as I think you put it, massive Jackie Chan fan.
Oh, I love the dude.
When did that start?
Well, I suppose it started with Bruce Lee. I was a huge Bruce Lee fan, and then straight into the Jackie Chan world. And to do this film with him was just, it was a kick in the pants. We didn't really get to know each other that well because his character was chasing my character. And when Jackie wasn't working, he was on a plane back to China to make another movie. So the man works.
When you did get to meet him, did you do the fan guy thing? Did you, I've always been a fan type thing?
I did. Yeah, I hugged him, I embraced him, I said, my God, Jackie, let me touch you, Jackie. he was so gracious, and he worked really hard on this film, because his English is good, but it's, when you do a drama, when you do a comedy, you can get away with blue murder, but when you do a drama, which this is, then you have to be more precise.
And by the way, he pays you a great compliment. He says you would get up very early in the morning to run lines with him, and he really appreciated that. Let me talk about the movie. It's based on a 1992 novel, but I know you feel, and I think a lot of audiences will feel, that there's a real degree of relevance in terms of maybe what we're going through today.
Well, it's dealing with terrorism. And so when you see, there's a scene in the movie which I actually got up on a Sunday morning to watch them do the explosion of the bus on the bridge. It really is, it's powerful, it's potent, it's relevant to what we see in our society today. I play a character who's a First Minister of Northern Ireland who was a terrorist. And so it's very close to the bone in that respect, but it is ostensibly it's a thriller. The book was written 25 years ago. The guy who wrote the book actually wrote the part for me as the young terrorist, but time goes on and now I'm playing the aging prime minister.
And while it is an action thriller and there's a lot of violence in the movie, there's also if you give it time and you're open to it, there's a message about peace in the movie.
There is. I mean, there's a great ambivalence, and that's what you want in drama. So you have the audience, thrown off center, so to speak.
Speaking of violent movies, you're about to take off and do the sequel to Mamma Mia.
At the end of this week, I shall be there in the middle of Dancing Queen.
The bloodshed in that movie alone. Oh. Is it as much fun to shoot a film like that with singing and dancing as it would appear to the untrained eye?
Oh, it's a hoot. It's a joy. I mean, it was criminal how much fun we had on making that movie. So we have the whole cast back. Meryl's back, Colin's back, Amanda. We're known as the legacy cast. And then underneath this, we have the younger versions of ourselves. So it's a prequel, sequel, without giving too much away.
You said to me one time, it was like two times ago where you were here, you talked about acting these days is kind of like a life force for you at this stage of your life and your career. What's a dream project? You've done, we were talking a second ago, you've had a great run, you've gotten to do all kinds of things. What's a dream project you would want right now?
Well, Martin Campbell, who directed this movie, The Foreigner, and who directed me in Goldeneye, we have a dream project. It's an Ernest Hemingway story called Across the River into the Trees. So that's a beautiful love story by Hemingway. So that's the dream. That's the closest dream. I never know what's going to happen next.
Family good?
Family are great. That's the main dream.
Yeah, every time I talk to you and I mention family, this broad smile comes on your face. Will you say hi at home for us?
I will indeed.
Pierce Brosnan, thank you very much. Good to see you. And The Foreigner opens in theaters this Friday.
Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.